Welcome to Spitsbergen, the largest island in the archipelago of Svalbard. It is here, 1,200 kilometers beyond the Arctic Circle and 1,200 kilometers from the North Pole, that the Polish polar station Honsund operates. Not far from the station lies the Hans Glacier, the best studied glacier in Svalbard. Today, we'll give you a chance to see it from the inside. And by the way, it was the Polish who pioneered glaciospeleological research, which is carried out inside glaciers. Do you know that ice caves and glacier caves are two very different things? Ice caves are caves which contain permanent ice deposits or drip formations. There is no flowing water inside them, and their walls are made of rock. Glacier caves are found inside glaciers. Their walls are made of glacier ice and rock material carried by the glacier. If you examine the walls a little closer, you may see the layering which has formed over the years. Because glaciers are constantly on the move, the annual layers are not horizontal, but distorted in all kinds of ways. The floor of a glacier cave may be ice or rock, as in our case. Inside glacier caves, water may flow throughout the year, though it's usually frozen in winter and spring. How do glacier caves differ from ice caves? Glacier caves tend to form a lot faster. The cave we're in was hollowed out by streams of supraglacial water, which is meltwater and rainwater initially flowing over glacier surface. Gradually, the water cuts deeper and deeper into the ice, carving labyrinths inside it. Now, the bottom of the cave is a channel for subglacial water, which flows beneath the glacier. The cave we're in formed in the terminus of the Hans Glacier in a spot where the glacier is only several meters thick. You can see rock material at the bottom and above a moulin, which lets in plenty of light. In deeper and longer caves, ice often looks like glass. It's hard to take a picture because light goes through it much like it does through a window pane, with nothing to reflect off. Glacier caves may contain ice, stalactites, stalagmites, and other drip formations. And inside the ice, you may see air bubbles, dust, and pieces of rock. Our trip inside the glacier is coming to an end. We're leaving the cave to see the terminus of the Hans Glacier, which in its central part flows into the Honsund Fjord.
Material was prepared for the project EDU ARCTIC 2, from polar research to scientific passion, innovative nature education in Poland and Norway, which receives a grant of €240,000 received from Iceland, Liechtenstein and Norway under EEA funds.